Well, I just finished a series on how to play American blues guitar in 6 weeks. And the way I did that was I took six iconic blues players and I broke down their styles into specific elements and techniques that they all use that's unique to them. Then during each week in a graduating difficulty level, I taught elements of each one of these great blues guitarists' solos. And then what I did is I played them against backing tracks so you have a context for them, so you know where these licks start, where they end, what chord they go over, and the tempo. And at the end, I provided and teach you three licks in the style of each one of these artists using the techniques and devices that I taught during the DVD. And then you get a 5 minute long backing track so you can practice these licks against the backing track or use the backing track to make up your own licks. I aim at the intermediate player primarily for this series. What I think is that it might be a little challenging for the person who just picked up the guitar for the first time. But if you've been playing a couple, 3, 4, 5, 6 months, I think you'll be able to get your head around this style. The techniques aren't too difficult. It's just a matter of practicing them. It's mostly exercises and physical technique that you need to work on. And then, of course, I didn't want to leave the advanced player out, so there's some ideas in there that are definitely targeted toward the advanced player. So I think all levels of player will get a great deal out of this DVD series. So my theory is this, that you have to learn before you can forget. And what I mean is this. In this DVD series, I taught you specifically techniques and licks in the style of these great players. But you don't want to sound like one of them exactly. You don't want to sound just like B.B. King. We already have a B.B. King. We don't need another one. We need you. So what I suggest that you do as a final tip is take these ideas and play them over and over again until you have them memorized. And then play blues over whatever kind of backing tracks you can find and try to mix and match the licks from all these different players. And then eventually the players' specific licks will dissolve and your own style will emerge.